everybody. Mac here. Welcome back to the show. It is week 3 of the Target Fall Geek Out, but we're also going to do a little bit of preview of the Hasbro PulseCon today as well. Once again, let me apologize for my voice. I don't know if you caught my video for Masters of the Universe Evil Lyn, card and link right here, but I'm a little under the weather, so that's why my voice sounds the way that it does. Also, I go on these coughing fits on occasion, so there may be a lot of quick jump cuts throughout this video. So sorry about that. But on to why you're here, which is week 3 of the Target Fall Geek Out. And what we have today is just one item, and it is this. The LEGO Ideas Magic of Disney set. Now, this is an 1,100-piece set. It's 1,103 pieces, actually. It is a LEGO Ideas set, and according to the video that they put up with it, it is also a Target-exclusive LEGO Ideas set with Disney. So, what is it? Well, basically, it's Disney. It's Mickey dressed up as the Sorcerer's Apprentice, and there's little diorama pieces spread out around him. You have Geppetto on the raft from Pinocchio. You have Simba on the rock from The Lion King. You have Beauty, Belle, in the room with the rose from Beauty and the Beast. There is Bruno from Encanto, which I don't know the scene. I never saw that movie. You have Lilo. I believe she's on the beach from Lilo and Stitch. And on the upper corner off his shoulder, you have the dancing brooms from, what was that, Fantasia, I think. So that's all they have dropping today. However, that might be more than enough, because being an 1,100-piece set, being a Disney property, and being an exclusive, I'm going to guess this is going to land around $150 to $200, just given that it's an exclusive, it's an idea set, and it's a Disney set, so there's that Disney tax added on to it. So I'm going to guess between $150 and $200. I may be way off. It may be below that. It may be above that. But that's just my guess for that. And like I said, that's all we have for the Fall Geek Out today. This is the halfway point. We got 3 more weeks of this left. If you were checking out those Thundercats figures from last week, both Lion-O and Monkey-N are both sold out. But I believe the Toho Godzilla Super Kaiju figures are still available. Now, moving on from the Geek Out to Hasbro PulseCon 2024, that we have a little bit of a preview for. This is the 5-year mark, so I don't know if that means they're going to go all out or whatever for this, but they're making a big deal on the website, on Hasbro Pulse at least, that this is the 5-year mark. And they've given us a timeline of what we can expect, and I'm just going to put that up on the screen right now so you can see that. That the PulseCon officially starts at 1 p.m. These are all Eastern time. So it starts at 1 p.m. Eastern time. At 12 p.m. Eastern time, there's a pre-show, which who knows what that means. The stuff I care about the most, luckily, is being taken care of right out the gate. At 1:10 p.m., we have G.I. Joe. And then at 1:30, we have Dungeons & Dragons. And I'll be honest, I'm pretty much going to check out at that point. Because Magic, I don't care about. The only thing I would care about with Star Wars is if they're releasing new figures for the Knights of the Old Republic line. Legends, there's not too much about Legends that I care about, unless they're bringing out more stuff for the Ghost Rider series. Like, I would love if they came out with Vengeance. And then at 3 p.m. is the Transformers. Now, here are the shopping windows, and this might be what rubs some people the wrong way, that at 4 p.m., Hasbro Pulse Premium members can start ordering, can start pre-ordering, can start ordering, however they want to phrase it. At 5 p.m. is when it's open up to the general public. Now, I think this is better. I really do, that 5 p.m. Eastern time is when everybody can start ordering things. I do think this is better. It's much better than when the windows open at like 12 or 1 in the afternoon Eastern time. I know that's still like 2 o'clock. That's still like 2 o'clock on the West Coast, but I think that is a much better time frame. And honestly, I wish they would just have these shopping windows open at this time all the time. rather than the early afternoon ones. So that's what we have for Hasbro PulseCon. I will more than likely be doing a video for PulseCon, but that won't be coming until much later in the day. May not even go live until tomorrow as sort of like a review video, just because I'll be at work and I won't get done with work until about 6:30. So this PulseCon will already have been over and the ordering window will be in full swing. So we'll have to wait and see, but I will be putting something out for that later, and more than likely it's just going to cover G.I. Joe and Dungeons and Dragons. And like I said, maybe if there's some KOTOR figures in Star Wars and some Midnight Suns stuff from Marvel Legends. But that's what we got. I know it's a short one this morning, but truthfully there's not much to talk about. Just one big LEGO idea set, and the LEGO idea set I think is kind of cool, but LEGO and Mega Constructs, now Mega is pretty much how this channel got started, but they just got so expensive that, like, I kind of lost interest in them. So, and I've never been a huge Disney fan, so this doesn't hold much interest for me, but I can see a lot of people really being into this. So I hope it does just land closer to the $150 mark, just for everybody that would want it. So that's what I got, and I'll see you later today, if not tomorrow. Don't touch that dial. Before you go, please remember to do all the YouTube things, like, share, comment, and subscribe. If you already are a subscriber, what a legend you are. If you like what we do here and you want to help the channel grow, please consider becoming a member, whether through YouTube memberships or our coffee monthly subscription. Links to that in the description below. Both of them for $1 a month, you can get access to exclusive content, such as our monthly member exclusive video. This month is the Hasbro G.I. Joe Classified Series Stinger. So until next time, my friends, play well, stay safe, stay healthy, and as always, thank you for watching.